Hey everybody, it's Mark Oakley here with another episode of From the Drawing Board, and today I thought I'd play with my camera a little bit because it's a gorgeous, we've got some nice light coming into the living room here, and I just felt like making a video. So the last video I made was that interview that I had with Daniel McFadden, and that was a lot of fun. Hopefully we've got a really good one lined up for tomorrow. It's a little bit, I gotta figure out. You know, you got to get beyond the technology, which is I've really learned a lot about, and I think I kind of had a good handle on it. I think there's a few little tweaks here and there, like got to sit closer to the microphones. We sort of sat down and had really good audio, and then as we relaxed in the interview, we sort of leaned backwards, and so they say you got to have like a fist distance between yourself and the microphone. You know, I set it up so that we can have a little bit more distance and get a good sound out of it. But we totally were just like, hey, how's it going? And we're like, you know, 2 feet away by the end of it. And the audio sort of changed quality over the course of the interview. Anyway, that's all neat. Tomorrow, hopefully, we're going to have a fellow in who is a businessman from the Valley, and they make a type of kombucha. And I wonder if I have a bottle of that floating around. Ah, let's go check that out. Let's follow along as we go into my kitchen. All right. So let's look down at, hang on. There we go. This Steadicam is such a weird alien device. Here we go. That's one of them right there. Oh, geez. Hope this is in focus. Let's see here. I want to make sure that everything's in focus. So something about that close, that's about in focus, I think. Okay, bring it back to me. So this is Solas Kombucha. And kombucha, well, hopefully he'll be able to explain what it is tomorrow if he comes in, but it's one of my favorite drinks. I basically have one of these every day, partly because they're tasty and partly because they're good for you. You know, they're a digestion aid, and I eat a lot of meats in my diet, and this just sort of like just balances things really great. Like, you know, a drink is good when you feel better after it. You know, like a can of pop, you don't usually feel much better. Maybe you feel worse after the fact, but I find this stuff, they say, you know, food is medicine. If you think of that way and you pick your foods with the mind of what sort of what makes you feel healthier and stronger, then, you know, that's you're embodying that philosophy. So this is part of that. Anyway, hopefully that'll come up tomorrow. If not, we'll hopefully get someone new in. So yeah, you know, learning the technology of how to run an interview program, that's one thing. Learning the the basic requirements of how to schedule interviews and appointments and get interesting people in, and what days are they available? Because a lot of the people that I want to talk to, you know, they're working people and they've got busy lives. And right now I've got scheduled like Tuesdays. That's when Zeus, my board guy, he's got free time. Tuesday's nice and open for me. But getting someone in the afternoon, oh, geez, if they have a regular job, that's not so easy. So we're sort of looking at how to make that work. I almost need like a secretary, just so I can, like, you know, have people booked in advance, because we thought we were going to get this other woman in, and she canceled because she just, you know, her life was busy and it was very, very short notice that we were giving. So we're having to sort of learn the particulars of how to run an address or a date book. So anyway, that's going on. The other thing I wanted to play with in this video was this particular camera. I haven't had a lot of chance, or haven't taken this outside yet, and I don't think I'm going to today. The light's just kind of going down. I don't feel like putting all my boots and coat and stuff on. But one of the things I'm learning about this lens, I got it specifically so that I could vlog with it, and I could have my head in the shot, and you know, and hold it at a comfortable distance like I am now. And you know, get a good image out of it. Looking at it now, I feel like I can sort of we can adjust how this looks here. Yeah, playing with this robot arm, such a weird piece of technology, this gimbal that's holding it nice and steady. So as I walk and bounce, the image stays nice and woo, nice and clear, except it's just got a weird little mind of its own. I'm having to like interpret my wishes through my arm to this thing that's trying to sort of like outguess me. It sort of will change its angle based on, I don't know, it's hard to figure out. Anyway, more learning to do with that. But the other thing about this particular lens is that it's such a weird technology, like that rectilinear quality, where for a fisheye lens, that's what this kind of is. It's sort of a, the next stage of evolution beyond fisheye, is that, you know, in another video, I demonstrated how lines don't curve. Like with a fisheye lens where you can get really, really close to it, like I'm only, you know, 10 inches away from the lens right here. One of the qualities of optics is that with a lens like that, you get like this beam back here, this thing is, you know, it, those lines will curve, but you'll notice that they're nice and straight with this image. But one of the other bizarre qualities that this lens doesn't fix is if I go off to the side like this, my head gets really elongated and strange, you know? And so I have to really kind of make sure that I'm dead center, otherwise I look like I've got some sort of birth defect. And that's, or maybe looking long like this is, there's maybe some cinematic value in there somehow. Anyways, so I'm just trying to sort of figure out, oh, see? Why are you over there? It's like, here I am, stay on me. Ah, I don't understand this thing. Oh, it's on lock. Hang on, I must have hit a button. There's too many buttons right in the grip section, right? So if you hit one, suddenly it's you know, yeah, right now it's in lock phase. Doesn't matter what I do, it's gonna ignore my wishes and do what it thinks that I want, which I guess I told it to by inadvertently hitting a button. So let's hit this M button again. Oh, see, now we're POV. See, now this is kind of cool. This is a neat system, right? I can walk around and kind of point it, and it will sort of take my points. Oh, you're moving your hand that way, you know. So it's a nice piece of artwork by Janesta Sky. I'm hoping to have her in the studio. She's a, let's see, here we go. She's a barista down at the cafe. And she's just one of those people that I just vibe with. You know, we just get into these weird conversations that just kind of like track nicely. And go, man, this is just fun. She's not really an expert in anything except perhaps living her life, but her life is so, I find her, she's just fascinating. I hope to have her on. She'd just be a really fun person to chat with on that interview show. And she said she would, but again, you gotta, you know, schedule things. She's a working girl. That's not what I meant. She's got a busy life and she has to, you know, you have to be really fortunate, or you got to get your date book skills down. There's several people like that. I just really want to sit down with me. There's another fellow, a guy named Dan Sparkman. I hope he'll come on. And he's just a guy who grew up in the Valley, but he's just had a really, really interesting life. He was a medic in the American military during, oh, one of the conflicts. And that's a strange thing because he's a Canadian, but he joined the American military, did medical work. And okay, so he did that for a year or two. What an odd experience. And then he was a town counselor. He said, you know what? I want to participate in the democratic process. And if I have complaints about how my city's run, well, who am I to complain if I haven't tried to make the changes myself? And so he ran in the election and became the youngest town counselor for like a year of Wolfville. It's like, who does that? Well, Dan. So I'm hoping to have him in. He's such a neat guy. And then it's just like, I have a list of people like that. Now, these are people that I've sort of met in my own life. But what I really, you know, to sort of expand the value of this interview show, I want to get people that I haven't met who have done really interesting things. And hopefully we've got that tomorrow, this fellow who makes this beverage that I enjoy every day. That'll be such a fun interview. If Zeus can set it up. He ran into him at Zeus works at a part-time at a little health food store that's sort of, you know, local Wolfville famous. And I guess the guy was coming into, you know, touch base with one of their, retail outlets because, you know, he sells his stuff all through the valley and just sparked up a conversation with Zeus. And Zeus was like, hey, dude, we have this neat show. And the guy was like, yeah, he was like excited to be on it. So I hopefully, that'll all work out, and tomorrow I'll get to sit down with him for a little while. Anyways, okay, that's probably enough updating and playing with my little weird gimbal camera here. And I hope you all have a wonderful afternoon. Oh, the sun's just going down. You can see the light quality changing. There it is in front of me. In like a few minutes, it's going to go down behind the trees. And it'll become a dark living room. I'll have to like artificially light everything. So I'll get into preparation mode for changing my environment. I'm going to do some drawing tonight. I've got... I've got a bunch of unreleased Jenny pages, which I'm just toning up now. Hopefully I'll get those out. I want to try and get those out soon, you know, in the next day or two. It's been far, 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 far too long. I've been very distracted with building studios. It's time to re-examine my roots and get some cartooning done. Anyway, okay, that's the longest goodbye ever. And, yeah, let's cut it off now. Hope you all have a wonderful evening. Love you all, and catch you again in another video. All right, cheers. Bye.